Okay, we have her back online. Davao City correspondent Kristen Bulosa now back with us. She's going to tell us more about that classroom shortage problem that's being experienced there in the city. Kristen, you were saying?
Carmina, as some schools here in Davao City struggle with the lack of classrooms, Capitan Tomas Monteverde Central Elementary School had to divide the class schedule to still implement social distancing inside the campus. For the kindergarten, each room is limited to 25 students, while grade 1 to 6 have 35 students max limit per class. Construction for the additional 20 classroom is still ongoing. There are about 4,300 students enrolled in the school, but according to the principal, some parents appealed to have the enrollment extended up to this week. Comparing from the previous tally of students pre-pandemic, there isn't really a remarkable difference in its numbers. Meanwhile, Carmina, here in Davao City National High School, classrooms are overcrowded with students. There are 50 to 70 students that are inside the classroom. So we can really see that there is a bit of a difficulty implementing the social distancing with this kind of situation. This is actually the biggest school here in Mindanao with over 15,000 enrollees this year. Carmina?
All right, Kristen, back to the shortage of classrooms. Why weren't those built? Everyone knew when the memo was handed down that, you know, schools were going to open again today. And then come November, no option for blended learning. It's going to be full on face to face. So again, why are the classrooms not there?
Well, actually, Carmina, here in Davao City National High School, it has been a problem, actually pre-pandemic, that there are shortage of classrooms already. But up until now, we still do not get an answer from the administration why the classrooms are still lacking, why a lot of students really had to endure the 3 shifts from morning and afternoon and evening shifts because, of course, the shortage of the classroom. Meanwhile, at Capitan Tomas Monteverde Central Elementary School classrooms, there are ongoing construction of 20 classrooms. But, of course, while the construction is still ongoing, we cannot really expect that it can be used by this year. Carmina?
Okay, so you're not even sure if that's going to be available to the learners come November?
Yes, the admin cannot really say and cannot really confirm whether or not the classrooms could be available for the students by November. Mm. Carmina?
Okay, what about the shifting? How many hours per shift, Krislyn?
From the principal, according to the principal of Capitan Tomas Monteverde Elementary Elementary School, there are actually 6 hours per shift. So basically, from the morning shift, it is from 6 a.m. to 12 noon, and then the second shift to follow will be from 12 noon to 6 p.m.
Uh-huh. And it's going to, all the shifts will be taught by the same teachers?
Actually, there isn't really an information from the principal if there are also shortage of teachers. But what we are certain about right now is that the classrooms are lacking and the students have to really congest and the classroom are jam-packed with students, especially here in Davao City National High School.
Yeah, do us a favor, Kristen. Maybe you can get more information regarding the teachers, because if one teacher is expected to teach 3 shifts per day, that's a lot. That's going to be a lot on the teachers. It would be good to know more about that. Thanks so much. Kristen Bulosan there joining us live from Davao.